وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى today we're going to start the explanation of the kitab أخلاق حملتي القرآن. This kitab is a kitab we thought that it would be wise and it would also be good to cover it in this month of Ramadan. Because the relationship between the Qur'an and Ramadan is very strong. It is the month in which the Qur'an came down, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us that the Qur'an was sent down in the month of Ramadan. And the bond between the Qur'an and the month of Ramadan is very strong. And the early pious predecessors, Salaf al-Salih, those who we were instructed to follow their way, they used to revive the recitation of the Qur'an, the studying of the Qur'an in this month of Ramadan. وَلِذَلِكَ it was mentioned that قَتَادَةَ بْنَ دَعَامَةَ السَّدُوسِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ that when Ramadan enters, he would stop all of his other classes and he would teach the Qur'an. So what we said to ourselves is, إِن لَمْ تَكُونُوا مِثْلَهُمْ فَتَشَبَّهُوا إِنَّ التَّشَبُّهَ بِالْكِرَامِ فَلَاحُ If you are not them, and if you are not the Salaf yourself, and you're not these imams, and we aren't, without a doubt, then imitate them, copy them. For verily, copying the pious predecessors itself is a virtue. Copying the righteous people itself is a virtue. So we want to follow them in this practice of studying the Qur'an and that which is related to it. The kitab that we have chosen, inshaAllah ta'ala, to cover is أخلاق حملتي القرآن. This kitab, inshaAllah ta'ala, before I start going through it, I want to go through two introductions, inshaAllah ta'ala, two muqaddimah, two introductions. The first introduction, I want to speak about the author of the book, and who is he? Because a person cannot value a book and honor it and place this book in its right status, in its right status and its position, if he doesn't understand the author of the book and who he is. وَلِذَلِكَ the scholars, they say, شَرَفُ الْكَلَامِ The honor of a speech is in accordance to the honor of the person who said it. The Qur'an is the best of speech because it's the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And any book that is authored by a scholar, the value of that book goes up in accordance to the value of the scholar and the greatness of that scholar. So if you don't know al-Imam al-Aajurri rahimahullah, the author of the book, you may not honor the book. Also, the second introduction I want to cover inshallah ta'ala is, what does this book talk about? And what is its relationship with the Qur'an? And how does it benefit someone to listen to this explanation of this book in the month of Ramadan? How does it benefit them? Inshallah ta'ala, that's the second introduction, bi'idhnillah al-kareem. So let me, bi'idhnillah al-kareem, start with the first introduction, and that is the author of this book. The way I hope to, inshallah ta'ala, speak about the author of the book is by five ways, inshallah ta'ala. I'm going to speak about the author of this book and who he is and a bit about him in five different perspectives, from five different ways, inshallah ta'ala. Once I cover those 5 points, you will inshallah ta'ala have a good understanding who the author of this book is. And then we're going to swiftly move on to the second introduction, which is a bit about the book, inshallah ta'ala, and a historical context to the book. And then the third, inshallah ta'ala, episode will be the book itself, inshallah ta'ala. The book itself, we will go into it straight away, bi'idhni Allahi al-Kareem. Without any further ado, inshallah ta'ala, I want to start by the introduction of the author and who he is. The first point that I want to speak about is ismuhu wa laqabu, the name of the author, and if he has a nickname as well. The author, rahimahullah, his name and his nickname, or his kunya is Abu Bakr. So his kunya is Abu Bakr. Kunya means if you are named after a child. Whether you have a child or not, if you are named the father of so-and-so or the mother of so-and-so. Our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she was called Ummi Abdillah. She was called the mother of Abdillah. We know our mother Aisha never had a child called Abdillah. She was named after her sister's son. Asma binti Abi Bakr had a son called Abdullah ibn Zubair. Because Asma bint Abi Bakr was married to Zubair ibn Awam, and Zubair had a son called Abdullah ibn Zubair. And so our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha is mentioned that she was named after that boy, Abdullah ibn Zubair radiallahu ta'ala anha. So sometimes a person can be given a kunya, Abu this and Ummu this, when they are not even married yet and they have no children. Ala kulli hal, his kunya is Abu Bakr, and his name is Muhammad ibn al-Husayn ibn Abdillah al-Aajurri al-Baghdadi. So his kunya is Abu Bakr. His kunya is Abu Bakr. And his name is Muhammad ibn al-Husayn ibn Abdillah. Muhammad ibn al-Husayn ibn Abdillah al-Aajurri. So he's called al-Aajurri. What does the word al-Aajurri mean? Ajurriyu means brick. It means a brick. وَلِذَلِكَ أَهْلُ الشَّامِ, the people of Sham, they call Ajur, the word Ajurri, they use another name for it, and they call it Al-Tubu. Whereas the people of Egypt, they call it Al-Qirmid. All means the same, which is brick. وَلِذَلِكَ حَافِظ الْحَكَمِي رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ, in his Aqidah book, he mentions Sulam al-Wusul ila ilm al-Usul, he mentions the term al-Ajur. He uses it and he says, فَانْظُرْ إِلَيْهِمْ قَدْ غَلَوْ وَزَادُوا وَرَفَعُوا بِنَاءَهَا وَشَادُوا بِشِيدِ وَالْآجُرِّ وَالْأَحْجَارِ لَا سِيَّمَا فِي هَذِهِ الْأَعْصَارِ. So he uses the word al-Ajurri. Hafiz al-Hakami used it. In the context of those people who use these bricks, and they use this cement to build the graves, when we were commanded to not build graves. Hafiz al-Hakami was talking it from that perspective. But what I want from the poetry of al-Hafiz al-Hakami is that he uses the word bishidi wal-ajurri wal-ahjari la siyama fi hadhihi al-a'sar. He used the word al-ajurri. So the word al-ajurri means brick in English. That's what his name was, rahimahullahu ta'ala. So now we know the author's name. That's point number one that I wanted all of you to know. We know his kunya. We know his nickname. Al-Ajurri was the nickname he had. And we also even know his actual name. He's called Muhammad ibn al-Husayn ibn Abdillah, rahimahullah. The second point that I want to, inshallah ta'ala, cover regarding the author is his upbringing and when and where he died. So I want to speak about his upbringing and also his death, where he died and when he died. Al-Imam al-Ajurri, this great Imam, he was in Baghdad. And he was born in Baghdad. He grew up in Baghdad. And he spent the first 50 years of his life that Imam al-Ajurri, the first 50 years of his life, he spent it in Baghdad. He didn't go outside Baghdad. He studied, he learned from the shuyukh of Baghdad for the first 50 years of his life. And the reason why he stayed in Baghdad and sought knowledge in Baghdad and he didn't leave for the first 50 years is because, as the historians and the ulama mentioned, like Khatib al-Baghdadi in his kitab Tariq al-Baghdad, also Ibn Khallikan in his kitab Wafayat al-Ayan, also al-Imam al-Dhahabi in his kitab Tadkirat al-Hufad, and also al-Imam Ibn Imad in his kitab Shudhur al-Dhahab, that كان علماء بغداد إذاك هم الدنيا, that the scholars of Baghdad at that time were the people that people travel to. يعني the scholars of Baghdad, people will travel the world to come to them. The knowledge was in Baghdad. Baghdad was موطن الخلافة. The Khilafah was in Baghdad. And so it passed everywhere in knowledge. It passed everywhere, even in worldly progression as well. The level Baghdad reached, nowhere else reached at that time. So he studied from the scholars of Baghdad, and this was في مطلع القرن الرابع الهجري, the fourth century. Because Al-Imam Al-Ajurri rahimahullah, he was born when the year was 280 Hijri approximately. 280 Hijri approximately. And he remained in Baghdad until 330 Hijriah. So that is 50 years. He used to study, or he studied in Baghdad. He sought knowledge from Baghdad. He remained in Baghdad for those 50 years. And when the year was 330 Hijriah, he went to Hajj that year and he went to Mecca. And when he went to Mecca, أعجبته, Mecca fascinated Al-Imam Al-Ajurri. He was fascinated with what he saw in Mecca. فأقام فيها, and he remained there for the 30 years remaining for his life. He remained there, rahimahullah, حتى توفاه الله فيها, until Allah took his life. And he died when it was the month Muharram, شهر محرم, شهر الله المحرم, when the year was 360 Hijriah. So he stayed in Mecca for 30 years. 50 years in Baghdad and 30 years in Mecca. So that means he lived for 80 years, rahimahullahu ta'ala. We've done the second part of the life of the author, rahimahullah, which is his upbringing and when he died and where he died. Now I want to go into the third part of the author's life, which is shuyukhuh, his teachers that he took knowledge from, and I also want to mention his students that took knowledge from him. I want to speak about his teachers, and I also want to speak about his students that took knowledge from him. Al-Imam Al-Ajurri, he has a kitab called Al-Sharia, and I'm going to be speaking about his books inshallah ta'ala. It is one of the points that I'm going to talk about. Al-Imam Al-Ajurri has a kitab called Al-Sharia, and it's an Aqidah related book. In there, he narrated from Al-Imam Al-Ajurri, in his kitab Al-Sharia, he narrated from more than 70 shuyukh, 70 teachers, more than 70 in that book, just that one book, Kitab Al-Sharia. And if you go to his kitab that we're going to study, inshallah ta'ala, this kitab, Akhlaaq Hamalati Al-Quran, this kitab that we're going to study, inshallah ta'ala, he has narrated from 24 shuyukh, 24 shuyukh. And those 24 are the same as those in which he narrated from the kitab al-Sharia. Yani these 24 are not extra to what is in kitab al-Sharia. He also wrote a book called 80 hadithan an 80 shaykhan. He has written a kitab which he called it 80 shuyukh, 80 teachers of his, 80 hadiths. 80 hadith from 80 different shuyukh. And I haven't seen that kitab yet. I don't know whether it's matbu' or makhtut, whether it's been published or not. I don't know. But what I do know is that Badr ibn Abdullah al-Badr, in the muqaddima of the tahqiq of his kitab, al-Arba'una Hadithan, he has a kitab called 40 Hadith. And al-Imam al-Aajurri preceded Nawawi in writing 40 Hadith. لذلك, al-Imam al-Nawawi mentions that in his muqaddima of his 40 Hadiths. And that he himself took it from al-Imam al-Aajurri, the idea of collecting 40 Hadiths, which then became something very famous. Scholars did it after that in large quantity. Al-Imam al-Aajurri has a kitab, 40 Hadith. The muhaqqiq of that kitab is Badr ibn Abdullah al-Badr. And he mentions in the muqaddima of the kitab, al-Arba'una Hadithan, he mentions that the shuyukh, the teachers of al-Imam al-Aajurri are 79. Tis'a wa sab'ina, 79. So it's close to the 80 that he mentioned in his book. يعني ثمانون حديثا عن ثمانين شيخا. The 80 teachers, 80 hadiths from them. The محقق of the كتاب الأربعون حديثا, he's close to it. 79. This really teaches us something very powerful. We learn something very great from this, which is how these scholars will take knowledge from many, many, many people. And how they would dedicate their lives in meeting great scholars of their time, taking knowledge from them, and not sufficing with one or two shuyukhs, let alone never going to a shaykh and never taking from a shaykh and just buying many books and reading them and thinking you're a scholar, or Googling up things, reading Wikipedia, and etc. These scholars, they, rahimahumullah, they took the knowledge from teachers, who their teachers took from teachers, who took from teachers, who took from teachers, and that's how they sought knowledge until the Prophet ﷺ. And so their chain goes back to the Prophet. And nowadays, وللأسف الشديد, we see people who think to themselves that seeking knowledge is watching a few videos here or there, also buying a few books here or there, and reading articles here or there, and then you're a mufti, you're an allama, you're an imam. Everybody should come back to you and see you as a reference point. فليت الشعر من أباح ذلك وأورط الأمة في المهالك فيا شديد الطول والإنعام إليك نشكو محنة الإسلام. That's all we can say. Right now, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to mention some of the teachers of al-Imam al-Aajurri. I'm going to go through the most prominent, the most famous ones of them, inshallah ta'ala. The first one, inshallah ta'ala, is al-Hafidh, al-Imam al-Hafidh, Shaykh Baghdad, Abu Bakr Abdullah ibn al-Imam Abi Dawud. Al-Imam Abi Dawud, his son, Abdullah ibn al-Imam Abi Dawud, Sulaiman ibn al-Ash'ar, Sijistani. Al-Imam Abi Dawud, the author of the Sunan, his son was the teacher of Al-Imam Al-Aajurri. And his son, Ibn Abi Dawud, has written many books. He has an Aqidah book called Al-Ha'iyya. And he also has a kitab called Al-Masahif. And many other works. His teacher, Al-Imam Al-Aajurri's teacher, is the son of Al-Imam Abi Dawud. Abdullah ibn al-Imam Abi Dawud. Abi Bakr, Abdullah ibn al-Imam Abi Dawud. From his teachers is the Muhaddith of Iraq, Muhammad ibn Muhammad ibn Sulaiman Abu Bakr al-Baghandi al-Wasiti. He's from his teachers that he took from. From his teachers is Al-Imam al-Hafidh al-Hujjah al-Mu'ammar Musnad al-Asr, Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Aziz Abu al-Qasim al-Baghawi rahimahullah. Al-Imam al-Baghawi was from the shuyukhs of Al-Imam al-Aajurri rahimahullah. The fourth shaykh of Al-Imam al-Aajurri is Al-Imam al-Muhaddith al-Qudwa, Shaykh al-Islam Ahmad ibn Muhammad ibn Ziyad Abu Sa'id ibn al-A'rabi al-Basri. And Ibn al-A'rabi is one of the ruwat of the Sunan of Al-Imam Abu Dawood. One of the narrators who narrated the Sunan from Al-Imam Abi Dawood is Ibn al-A'rabi. So it's one of the riwayat that we have from Sunan Abi Dawood is the riwaya of Ibn al-A'rabi. Ibn al-A'rabi is the shaykh of Al-Imam al-Ajurri, rahimahullah. So he took from him when he was in Mecca. لِأَنَّ الْإِبْنُ الْعَرَابِي is نَزِيلُ مَكَّةَ وَشَيْخُ الْحَرَمِ. He was a resident in Mecca and the shuyukh of Mecca. The fifth is Al-Imam Al-Hafidh Al-Allama Shaykh Al-Islam Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Ziyad Abu Bakr al-Naysaburi. These are the shuyukhs that are well known from the shuyukh of Al-Imam Al-Ajurri rahimahullah. And as I said, his shuyukhs have actually reached up to 79, 80 shuyukh he has that he has taken from. But these are some of his shuyukhs. As for his students that took from him, فكثيرون, they are too many in number. ولعلهم لا يقلون عن عدد شيوخه. And maybe they are not even less than his teachers. Maybe the students that he has are probably even 80 plus students. They are probably 80 plus students, or even more than that. Because he stayed in Baghdad for 50 years. Let's just say the first 30 years he was studying and he was gaining knowledge. The last 20 years he was narrating and he was teaching and he was educating. So his students are large in number as well. From the famous students that he has is Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani, the author of the kitab Hilyatul Awliya wa Tabaqatul Asfiyya, is from the students of who? Al-Imam al-Ajurri. Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani, his name is Ahmad ibn Abdullah ibn Ahmad, is a student of Al-Imam al-Ajurri. From the students of Al-Imam al-Ajurri is Al-Imam al-Faqih, al-Qudwa, al-Abid, Ubaydullah ibn Muhammad ibn Battah, Abu Abdullah al-Ukbari. Ibn Battah, the author of the kitab Al-Ibana, is the student of Al-Imam al-Ajurri, rahimahullah. And the third one that I want to mention is Al-Imam al-Muhaddith, al-Muqri, Baghdad. He's the Muqri of Baghdad. So Al-Imam al-Muhaddith, Muqri of Baghdad. Ali ibn Ahmad ibn Umar Abu al-Hasan, al-Muqri al-Hammami. Al-Hammami is rawi هذا الكتاب. He's the narrator who narrated this kitab from Al-Imam al-Ajurri. This kitab that we're going to study, أخلاق حملة القرآن. The narrator who narrated it from Al-Imam al-Ajurri is Al-Hammami. And also the other kitab, أخلاق العلماء. أخلاق العلماء. That Al-Imam al-Ajurri writ. The narrator of that kitab is also Al-Hammami. Rather, when you look at the nusakh, Al-Makhtuda, the manuscripts of this kitab that we're going to be doing, inshallah ta'ala, Akhlaaq Hamalati Al-Quran, and the other kitab on the ulama that he wrote, both of them are generally the nusakh, the makhtuta, are generally together. Yani they're together, both of them, because they're from one of his students that narrated it from him. Now, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to go into the fourth point that I wanted us to know about the author of the kitab, inshallah ta'ala. And that is his works and the books that he has authored, مُؤَلَّفَاتُهُ. The author of this kitab, Al-Imam al-Ajurri, what works does he have? And how many books has he written? Al-Imam al-Ajurri, as Al-Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi said about him, he said, لَهُ تَصَانِيفِ, he has works which are كَثِيرَة, large in quantity. His works are large in number. Al-Yafi'i, he said, وَصَنَّفَ فِي الْحَدِيثِ وَالْفِقْ كَثِيرًا. He authored in hadith. And he has also written books in fiqh, and they are large in quantity. وَلِذَلِكَ, if you look at the books that are mentioned from Al-Imam al-Ajurri, you will not find a list which goes through it all at one after the other in the makhtutat, other than what the muhaqqiqin mentioned. But there is no قائمة كاملة في أيدي الباحثين which show the مؤلفات of الإمام الأجري. على كل حال شيخ الألباني رحمه الله شيخ محمد ناصر الدين الألباني رحمه الله in the مخطوطات of the كتب الأجري في دار الكتب الظاهرية شيخ الألباني mentioned that the works of this great Imam are 11 كتابا only 11 شيخ الألباني only mentioned 11 works of his. We have another Orientalist, a Turkish Orientalist. His name is called Fuad Zazkin, Sazkin, who died the year 124. Orientalist, I don't think he's a Muslim. على كل حال, he mentions that his works are 15 كتابا. He only mentions that they are 15. Abdullah ibn Abd al-Rahim, Usaylan, in the muqaddimah of the kitab that he did the tahqiq of, Akhbaru Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, that al-Imam al-Ajurri writ, he done a tahqiq of the kitab. He mentions that the books are 27 kitaban. 27. Al-Ustadh Umar Gharama al-Amrawi, the Saudi muhaqqiq, who's still fi qayd al-haya, he has a tahqiq of the kitab, Tahrimu al-Nard. That Al-Imam Al-Ajurri wrote. He done a tahqiq of that kitab. He mentions that his books are 37 kitab. That they are 37 kitab. That's how much he mentions. But there is a side point that or a point that I want him to mention, which is there's a kitab called Laylatu Nisf Min Sha'ban Wa Fada'iliha and its virtues that is attributed to Al-Imam Al-Ajurri rahimahullah. This kitab was attributed to Al-Imam Al-Ajurri. Rather, the tahqiq of this kitab was done by Amr Abdul Mun'im Salim. He did the tahqiq of the kitab and he attributed this book to Al-Imam Al-Ajurri. The book can actually be found in Darul Kutub Al-Misriya. You can go find it. The number is 26. This book is actually not owned or it's not from the works of Al-Imam Al-Ajurri. Even though many of the muhaqqiqin of this, the works of Al-Imam Al-Ajurri, they add this to the list. The kitab is actually written by a mu'arrikh from the historians of Iraq, known as Abi Abdullah Muhammad ibn Sa'id al-Dubaythi. Dubaythi wrote that kitab. Actually, if you go to the makhtutat, of this kitab, you find it attributed once to Dubaythi and sometimes attributed to Al-Ajurri. And the person who I saw mention this, or I came across mentioning this, is Dr. Ahmed Imam, the Somali Sheikh, Dr. Ahmed Imam. And I spoke to him about it, and he himself verified for me and told me that this is the case, that this kitab is not written by Imam Al-Ajurri rahimahullah, and that the kitab is written by this لمؤرخ العراق مؤرخ العراق أبي عبد الله محمد بن السعيد الدبيثي written. على كل حال, I'm going to mention five of his works. There are more than that, but I'm just going to mention five prominent ones. The first one is the kitab الشريعة في بيان عقيدة أهل السنة والجماعة والرد على طوائف أهل البدع على طوائف أهل البدع والضلال. ذات الإمام الأجري writ. And it's short for the kitab, كتاب الشريعة by الإمام الأجري. This kitab is عقيدة book. And as you can see, الإمام الأجري here, he doesn't just mention عقيدة أهل السنة in this book. What he mentions in this book is the عقيدة أهل السنة, and he also refutes the statements of the Ahlul Bida'i wa Dalal, the people of misguidance and innovation. Also, Al-Imam Al-Ajurri wrote another kitab called Adab Al-Nufus, where he talks about the actions of the heart, heart softening things. He has another kitab called Ahkam Al-Nisa, jurisprudent rulings regarding women. He also has a kitab called At-Tahajjud wa Fada'il Qiyam Al-Layl. He speaks about the Tahajjud and virtues related to Qiyam al-Layl. And inshallah ta'ala, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us to live, Maybe we might go through that, inshallah ta'ala, for next year Ramadan, inshallah ta'ala. Also, he's written another kitab called At-Tawbah, where he speaks about repentance. Now, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to speak about the fifth and final point that I want us to know about the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, is مكانته العلمية. What credentials does this great imam hold? In other words, what have the scholars said about him? So I want to talk about his credentials, وأقوال العلماء فيه. I want to speak about his credentials and what he's achieved, and the statements that scholars have said about him. So the scholars, what they say about him is actually going to be enough for us to know his credentials and his positions. Ibn Nadim mentioned about him and said about him, he said he is al-faqih, he's a jurist. He said, أَحَدُ الصَّالِحِينَ الْعُبَّادِ. He's from the righteous people and from the worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني he was a person who جَمَعَ بَيْنَ الْعِلْمِ وَالْعَمَلِ. He combined between knowledge and action. Khatib al-Baghdadi said about him, he is thiqa, وَكَانَ thiqa. He said he's sudduq, and he is also dayyinan. كان ثقة صدوقا دينا, a trustworthy person, reliable individual in his religion, and a person of great religion. Ibn al-Jawzi said about him, جمع العلم والزهد. He combined between knowledge and being an aesthetic individual. He also said about him, كان ثقة دينا عالما مصنفا. He said he's a reliable person, great integrity, a person of great Islamic knowledge. And he said he's an author. He's authored many works. Ibn Khallikan, in his kitab al-Wafayat al-Ayan, he said about him, al-faqih al-shafi'i al-muhaddith. Al-imam al-Aajurri is a shafi'i in fiqh. He's a muhaddith. Wa kana salihan abida. And he was a righteous man, a worshipper of Allah. So he's a shafi'i in fiqh. But that doesn't mean he blind follows the great imam, al-imam al-shafi'i. He goes with the truth wherever it is, whether it's in the Shafi'i madhab or not. But in his base and his foundation, هو على مذهب الإمام الشافعي. شمس الدين الذهبي, an Imam al-Dhahabi رحمه الله, he said, كان صدوقا خيرا عابدا صاحب السنة واتباع. He said, an Imam al-Aajurri is a trustworthy person. He's a great person, righteous individual, worshipper of Allah. And he's also sahib al-sunnah, a person who held on to the sunnah. Wattiba', a person who followed the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibn Imad al-Hanbali, he said about him, al-muhaddith, al-thiqa, al-dabit, sahib al-tasanifi wa sunnah. He said he's a scholar of hadith. He's a trustworthy individual. He's a precise person. Precision is what he has. He is also an author, has written many works. And he said he's also a sahib al-sunnah, a person who's holding on to the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So inshallah ta'ala, those are the five things that I want all of us to know about this great imam, an Imam al-Aajurri rahimahullah. An Imam al-Aajurri is the author of this kitab that we're going to be studying, Akhlaaq Hamalati Al-Quran. Now that we've taken that first introduction, inshallah ta'ala, in our next episode, I'm going to speak about the book itself and what it's about. And then we'll start the book, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.